survival. My name is Lonnie, and I am really glad that you joined me. I have received a bunch of requests lately on how to start a fire when everything's wet or when everything's covered in snow. So a lot of these techniques, just about all these techniques here that I'm going to show, I've covered in past videos, but we've grown by over 11,000 new subscribers in the last 30 days alone. So to a lot of you, this will be new. Let's get started. Okay, first off, we're going to need a dead standing tree. All right. Now, you see quite a few. Most of these here are alder. But these are laying down. These are sideways, okay? Notice the snow on top of them. Okay, and this is a sunny day today. Point you over there towards the sun. It's a beautiful fall day. Okay, so that snow is going to be melting a little bit, and it's going to be soaking into that wood. So we don't want something that's laying over. We want something that is more upright. And I found a dead one over here. Okay, this one right here. Notice that it is, there's no snow on it. Okay, so I'm gonna cut it down. It's dead, and I'll show you what's next. Okay, I've got my wood cut up there, ready to go. Now, notice on this log, there's some old tracks are kind of snowed in now of probably squirrel. But let's get started here. All right. Now, what I'm going to do is this is bigger than I need. And here in the North Country, the rain or melting snow water, it will only soak in maybe an eighth of an inch around the outside. So you get beyond that in here and it'll be dry just about all the time. If you're using a dead standing tree. So that's what we're gonna go after. Now, of course, you could use a hatchet or an axe if you have that with you. But I'm gonna use this knife that a viewer sent me from Norway. I'm looking for a side that is as not free as possible. So I'm going to take this side. It looks like it has less knots. All right, now what's next? We are in the dry interior, and that's what we're after. So, I'm going to take off my jacket. Okay, appears to be another log that's frozen in, so we'll just leave that there. And we'll work around it. Now you'll see why I'm taking off my jacket here in a second. We're gonna make some shavings. Okay, now that we've got quite a pile of shavings, we're cutting up the rest of this, splitting up the rest of this into smaller pieces. I've got my shavings piled up here, and I've got my splits into some separate organizations. So let's light this up. Now, to light this, I'm going to use I forget what they call this. Slow match, I think. What this is cotton string that I wove together and dipped it in wax. So, let's get it lit up. Incidentally, this will light with a ferro rod. All right, let's go ahead and light the fire. Get this burning. Okay, now need to be careful, carefully lay this on here so that you don't put the flames out. And what I'm gonna do right now is another little trick. This is catching on real nice, so I don't really even need this, but I want to show it to you anyway. This is a back scratcher that I took the ends off of. This is really better to use, more practical to use once you've got some coals established. But you can see that this is catching on just great. Now, it doesn't matter that this wood is froze. A viewer recently told me, and you know who you are, he recently told me about an old John Wayne movie where they were out surviving. It was a survival situation, and they didn't light any fires because the wood was frozen, and frozen wood won't burn. Well, as you can see, that isn't true. Frozen wood burns just fine.
Okay, I'm going to speed this up, and so you'll see how it progresses. Got this fire established. You can see that it's going well on its own. It's establishing some coals. It's taking off real well. You can see that it's established. So let's go on to the next method, and I'll show you that.
Okay, the next thing we're after is we're gonna go to the spruce tree. It's going to supply us everything we need to start our fire. Now, what we're looking for is a spruce pitch like this here. Over here is some more right here. So we're going to gather up a bunch of this, and we'll take it back to our fire building spot. And there's something else. So let's go over here to this spruce tree over here. Now, underneath the spruce trees here in Alaska, you'll just about always find dead branches. Now, this spruce tree here happens to be dead, the whole tree. But under just about all the spruce trees, see, here's a live one. As you can see, okay, there's dead branches. And even when it's raining, you'll still find branches underneath. And that's what you're looking for. You want to hear that snap. That means that they're dry inside. Okay, so we're going to gather up some of those, and I'll meet you over at the fire area. All right, we've got a little pile of spruce pitch together here. Now we're gonna, I'll show you how to use these spruce boughs. Okay, you'll notice we've got some thicker branches here, and we've got some thinner branches. So it's the thinner branches we're after, especially when everything's wet. When everything's covered in snow or rain, that's what we want, is those thinner branches. So we'll gather up some of them, and then we'll light our fire.
Okay, we're ready to light our fire, and what I'm going to use for this fire is matches. Hopefully I've got some smaller matches here. Yeah, here's some. I also have my stormproof matches that I carry with me as well. But for now, we're just going to use these. Okay, we're going to lay that match, that burning match, right on the pitch like that. And if it works right, it'll start wicking up that pitch. And yeah, it is, it's taken off and wicking the pitch just fine. So now we lay these on top, and that pitch will burn long enough that even if these are wet, it'll dry them out and it'll start to catch. All right, now, this is already catching real well since these are dry. But like I said, even if they're wet, they'll catch just fine. So now we can feed on bigger sticks and build our fire up. So as before, I'm going to go ahead and speed this up so you can see the progression of the fire without having to wait here for the whole duration. So here we go. As you can see, we've got a well-established fire here. I'm not concerned at all that this would go out. It's well-established. And if you had a sharp eye, you might have noticed that I had some birch bark over here. Some of you are probably wondering, why don't I use birch bark to light a fire? Well, birch bark is my favorite way of lighting a fire, but not everybody has birch bark. So I'm using methods here, showing some methods that are a little more universal, hopefully, and hopefully it'll give you some ideas. But for those of you who may not be familiar with birch bark, let me show you how easy this lights. There you go. It'll light even when it's wet. I did a video a while back where I soaked some birch bark in water, and it lit up real well, even after I pulled it out of the creek in the video. All right, now, there's one other method that I'm going to show. These are not necessarily the best methods. Like I said, birch bark is my favorite. But these are other methods to keep in mind in case you don't have your favorite method available. Maybe these will work for you. All right, let's go get started on that other method. I'll show you what that involves. Now, in many areas here in Alaska, especially in southern exposed sides of openings, low areas, meadows, muskegs, you will find grass. Now, even during the winter, as you can see, you can find grass underneath the trees. Now, the problem with this grass is even with the snow off of it, you gather it up, a bunch of this and try to light it, you're probably going to discover in most cases that it's quite damp and doesn't want to light. So what you do is you gather it up. This is particularly good for friction fire tinder nest, because these fine little leaves, the blades of the grass, they'll catch real easy from a ember. Friction fire ember. Okay, so you gather this up and I'll show you what to do with it. Okay, so you gather it up and I always carry a bandana with me. So spread out your bandana, lay your grass in there. Incidentally, tree lichens, what a lot of people call old man's beard, that's the same way. During the winter, oftentimes even during the summer, it will be too damp to burn, but wrap it up in a bandana, handkerchief,
Or barring that, if you don't have anything to put it in, just put it in your pocket. I carry it in my front pockets, and even after 1 hour of walking around, you'll notice a difference. But gather it during the day when you're out hiking, and then in the evening when you're let me get it out here. In the evening, when you're ready to start your fire, your grass should be good and tender. Your grass should be good and dry. Okay. Now, I've been carrying this for probably an hour. And I'll show you how it lights now. There, hopefully you can see that. It lights real well. Whereas this stuff, of course, you guys can't feel it, but I feel it's very damp. There's no way this is gonna light. It's just too damp. It's just too wet. So, that's some tips. That's by no means covers everything, but hopefully it gives you some ideas that will help you next time you're out when it's wet to get a fire lit. Well, thanks for joining me, and we'll catch you on the next video. And to all you new subscribers and to my old viewers, thanks a lot. I really appreciate you guys and gals. I really do. You guys have a good one, and you take care. We'll see you on the next video. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.